today just to show you some background of where I grew up on a farm and some of the cultural things that happened that shaped me as a person and shaped me as an artist. On a farming background, you are dependent by your daily handwork. What my work deals and speaks about is physical activity that is involved in farming activity. I use it as a metaphor for painting, and the time-consuming factor that is part of the production of doing a painting is also involved in farming activities. I usually work in large-scale painting. I don't sit down, I stand. My paintings can be viewed as a physical attack of marks and color, and the layering and the interview of these layers. And for me, this is the theatrical aspect to my work, you know, moving forward, standing back, and also things are always changing. You don't see things this way, it's constantly moving and constantly shaping. So I'm going to start. This is the home where I grew up. It was designed by Erich Meyer, the painter. He was married to my grandfather's older sister. My grandfather also had a very large collection of Erich Meyer paintings and drawings. And from a very early age, I was exposed to these works. Just to give you an idea of the landscape. And also, if you look at the landscape, this layering, these marks and this direction and movement. A big thing in my work is the fact that everything, if you say on a farm, you have to make things, and things have history and things have a sense of usefulness. It's not like in a city where you have a lot of consumerism and things that you can just buy, go to a shop and buy something new. On a farm you have to deal with aspects like preparing things. And also my horse plays a very important role in my life, because galloping through a landscape give you the feel of space and give you the feel of the landscape. And also family ties is very important, and farming traditions and Sakwesi's, Hoenderaanvang, Aansamwesi's, Tuitplek, and yeah, here's my paintings. In my work I use a lot of metaphors. Cows, I see them as a metaphor for the voices, and in a sense, people that live on farms experience the continuous thing of surviving. I think there's a great sense of survival on a farm, because you have to deal with a lot of elements and also prices and uncertainties, and I see the cows as asking questions, and you can see they are on their way to the slaughtery. When in my exploration of portraits, this painting is 2 meters by 1.25, and for me it's portrait landscape but also landscape portraiture. Some of these people, they live so close to the land that the texture of their skin almost become like texture from landscape. And there's just a detail, another detail, a little calf in the dip. This is per installation which I've recently done for the Kalkan calf of this year. It's 8 paintings that is in a box, and you are meant to be alone in this box, and I've taken some of the shots from the Disgrace of John Malkovich, and for me it's a symbolize of somebody that is so iconic as John Malkovich, that played in a movie about South African farm leaders and stuff, and yeah, I spray paint in these paintings, and some of my charcoal drawings, this is another one of that series. And another charcoal drawing, and and now I've come to the work that one outside of here. This work for me, it started off with the TV series of Boerskevrou, And for me, it's actually a very strange program, and it seems a little bit belachelijk. you know, and I was thinking about metaphors, how to make an artwork out of it, and because I work with metaphors, I was thinking about the whole thing of exhibitionism and voyeurism, and in a sense, for me, the music is very much about both of them. So, in the work that you will answer, I decided I'm going to take on a little bit of Holy Cows. And I just want to mention, very importantly, the work of the video is that you can see in the monument that is mounted at the top. This is the video that I'm going to show you now.
Kijk, een vrouwse rol is voor mij baie belangrijk. Een vrouw is nou 90% van een manse succes. Hoe ek in die ochtend uit die huis uit gaan, bepaal hoe my dag gaan wees. Dit bepaal hoe my werksverhouding met my werksmense gaan wees. En met enig iemand anders. So, kyk, wanneer ek nou uit die huis uit gaan en wanneer ek terugkom by die huis, dit moet my veilige plek wees. Dit moet 'n tuiste wees waar ek regtig kan rus en ontspan. Sy moet ondersteunend wees, sy moet ook sensitief wees vir my behoeftes. Ek dink die liefde oorwin als sy kan haarself kom uitleef op die plaas ook, ja. Sy moet met tye ook by my wees om saam met my te ry. Ja, maar die huis is haar, sy maak en breek wat sy wil daar. Ja, ek is nie lief dat sy heel dag in die son staan nie. Sy kan huis skoon maak, kos maak en haar eie aktiwiteite hier op die plaas doen. Ek meen, as sy dit kan regkry, dis haar doel en dis wat ek dink die beste is. He? Ja. Sy moet vir my aanmoedig en sy moet my kan bystaan in tye van nood en in tye waar dinge nie so lekker gaan nie, vooral op die plaas. En sy moet saam met my drome kan droom. Ja, my liefie. Daar is die papierwerk. Daar is die, gaan haal gauw vir my dit, gaan haal gauw vir my dat. Sy moet tevrede wees om by die huis te bly, om na die kinders te kyk. Een vrou moet haarself kan besig hou. Sy moet 'n vlytige en deugsame vrou wees. Sy moet weet, sy moet besef, boerdery is 'n leefstyl. Jy trou nie net met my nie, jy trou met my boerdery ook. En sy moet het weet en besef, jy kies 'n boerdery lewe vir die rest van jou lewe.
Die werk het baie te doen met ironie wat volle cirkel geloop het. Irony that made a full circle. En as you this the role of a woman, the question that I ask of this work is, does a farmer choose his future wife the same way he breeds his stud cattle? And if you think about farming, the main stud bull, I mean, that is the pride of the farm, and that is that everything is just around that. And the way I've mounted the installation is on a obelisk, a gedenk, not only in the Afrikaans term, but also a phallic symbol. And the old phone line hand telephone set. So as the viewer, you are forced to listen in voyeuristically. I don't know, all of you didn't grow up in the form of a shared hand phone system, and And if you think about before the time of television and internet and Skype and the privacy of cell phones, there was a shared hand clone system. And I grew up, the farm where I grew up, there was a shared hand clone system. And you could hear the people that was listening in, some ladies had an old clock or geese at the back or something like that. So I made use of the phone line hand telephone to force you as the viewer to stand very close to this installation and to listen in and also to watch the video. And also the aspect of the monument. A lot of the farmers in the series choose, some of the participants choose the wife to be a trophy. And in, the trophy is a static or a status symbol, and a monument can, for me, can be viewed the same. And also, if you look at the bull in the pen, for me, it's also the aspect of the male in this construct, and the male have to perform and produce. And